Hi viewers, this is Sri Ramalu. So today's topic is a moving coil ballistic galvanometer. So what is a ballistic galvanometer? When a very short current is passed through the galvanometer, the coil begins to perform angular oscillations about its own axis. So that means this is a galvanometer, and then this coil, what happens, you know, it starts swinging like this. So not like this, in this manner swing it, they swings like this, okay. That is called twisting. The maximum deflection is directly proportional to the total charge passed through the galvanometer. Maximum deflection, so this end come this side and this end goes out that side, and next this come this side and this come that side. So then maximum twisting will occur, deflection will occur. So that is because of when charges passes through the galvanometer, then only maximum deflection will occur. Next, construction. A moving coil ballistic consists of a rectangular coil PQRS of a large number of turns of fine insulated wire wound over a non-conducting frame of ivory or bamboo. Okay, ivory or bamboo are the generally they are insulated. Bamboo means bamboo stick. Okay, so these are the ivory means it is the teeth of elephant teeth. This coil is suspended. Here. A moving coil ballistic consists of what? A rectangular shape is rectangular shape. Coil PQRS of large number of turns. So many times it is wounded. Okay. A fine insulated wire means very small thickness and on it insulations will present. And it is a non-conducting frame of ore. So it is wounded on non-conducting frame of ivory or bamboo sticks. Means they can act as a insulator, non-conducting frame. This coil is suspended by means of Prosper branch wire. So see the wire. This wire is a Prosper branch wire. Between the pole pieces of powerful horseshoe magnets. So it is one horseshoe. Horseshoe means their shape is like a harsh leg shape. So that is called horseshoe. The poles of magnets are curved to make the field radial. So what is the meaning of radial? So when the poles are like this curved, then what happens here, if it is a pole and its field is in this direction, its field is in this direction, this field is in this direction. So that means in the middle maximum field has to present, and away from this middle field gradually decreases. So like this, in this manner only these are designed in these shapes. Okay, so curved shape because of getting maximum field in the middle of this magnets. This coil is suspended by means of Prosper branch. So wire, yes, right. Next, poles, right. Okay, the lower end of the coil is attached to a spring of Prosper branch. So it is a Prosper branch spring, right? It is a Prosper branch spring. To it, a certain weight is attached. The spring and the free ends of Prosper branch wire are joined to two terminals T2 and T1 respectively on the top of the case of the instruments. See here, there are the two. At the two places we have what the ones at one, what at one end T2 weight is there, at another end it is attached to the rigid support. See the diagram. So it is a rigid support, it is attached to our torsional head, and this weight is attached. It is a T2 and it is a T1 end. A small mirror, capital M, is attached on the suspension wire. So here on small mirror, mirror is attached on suspended wire. Using lamp and a scale arrangement, deflection of the coil can be recorded. Here in front of this mirror there is a lamp, so lamp light can fall on it, and when the light falls on it, it starts reflecting, and reflected light falls on a curved shape or semicircular scale. So where they are falling, there we take the readings. Okay, for the correct measurement of charge, the whole discharge must pass before the coil of galvanometer has moved appreciably. Suppose if you want to measure the exactly charge, then what it has to do? Discharge must pass before the coil galvanometer has moved. So before moving the coil, before twisting the coil, total discharges has to discharge. So then only we get exactly value. Next, thus the time of swing should be greater than the time of discharge. So time of discharge means discharge here, time of swing must be greater than the time of, means very fast discharge has to occur than the swinging time. Swinging time, how much time? Let for example, swinging is taking 10 seconds, then discharge must take less than the 10 seconds only. To fulfill this requirement, the moment of inertia of the coil must be large and torsional couple must be small. So momentum of inertia must be large means more weight we have to attach. Why? Inertia depends on mass. If the mass is more, inertia is more. Okay. And what is one thing small? Torsional couple must be small. Torsional couple means a twisting couple. Twisting. So torsional couple twisting means the force can act on the rectangular coil. One force will act in this direction, other one force act opposite direction. The opposite forces of equal magnitude is called simply couple. Couple means two pair of forces. The ballistic galvanometer is constructed in such a way that moment of inertia of the coil is large. So moment of inertia must be greater, very much high. I value must high. Next, theory of ballistic galvanometer. Ballistic galvanometer. When a charge is passed through the galvanometer coil, it gives angular impulse. Angular impulse means within short time maximum force will act. Right? So within short time maximum force will act. That is called impulse. The coil must set into the oscillation. So like this. Okay, within short time coil has to oscillate like this. The momentum of couple is called torque. Torque is given by torque formula is already this day equation is derived, and this video also uploaded for this derivation. That is a video name is torque on a loop. Torque on a loop. So please watch that video, then only you can understand how we derived this relation. Okay, so now tau is equal to NIAB, where N is the number of turns, A is area, B is a magnetic field, right? And the next, the torque acting for infinitesimal time dt. Infinitesimal time dt means it is very short time or very small time, that is called infinitesimal time. So that small time is denoted by dt. Okay, gives an angular impulse to the coil. So torque which acts on the small time, that gives angular impulse to the coil for twisting. So angular impulse is what? Simply force into time or couple into time. So that couple is already we have taken as tau. So tau value is substituted here and time value is substituted. So that means here tau into time. So tau into time formula. So tau value is NiAb. Time is a small time, that is a dt. So next, if t be the total time, then total angular impulse can be written as 0 time to maximum. NiAb dt integrating. So integrating what we get? Integration I dt. Integration 0 to I dt is simply this indication of charge. But angular impulse is equals to change of angular momentum, that is I omega. Change of angular momentum. Angular momentum. So angular momentum means dl by dt. Change of angular momentum can be written as I omega. So where I is inertia and omega is what? Angular velocity. Now it is an angular impulse, and angular impulse means tau, simply angular impulse. Okay. So angular impulse is equal to change of momentum. Change of angular momentum is, that is I omega. Angular impulse is this one. So making these two equation equal, that is, and squaring we get this one. Let it is equation 1. Kinetic energy of the moving system in the initial position is half I omega square at initially. But initially means at the beginning, the move body moves, the twisting will occur, and when it reaches here, then its kinetic energy at final position is 0. In the final position, kinetic energy of the coil is 0. If the damping is absent, means while it is twisting, no air opposes the twisting. If the air opposes the twisting, then what happens? Its amplitude gradually decreases, that is called damping. So without presenting damping, in the absence of damping, decreasing kinetic energy is used for doing work in twisting the suspension. So decreasing kinetic energy can be used to twist the suspension, means while. Let theta be the theta is the angle through which coil has turned, coil has moved. The couple for this twist can be written as C theta, where C is called couple. Okay, so for work done for additional small twist. So at the beginning, so this much of twist has occurred. Next, additional small twist means, that is simply we write D theta. So work done for an additional small twist d theta can be written as c theta d theta. Okay. If the maximum angle of twist is theta naught, it is a maximum value. Okay. So whatever value is present, all the values must be less than this value. Then the work done is given by integration. So total work done is given by integrating 0 to theta naught. So minimum value to maximum value, c theta d theta. Here C is constant, theta integration with respect to d theta is what? Theta square by 2. If it is x is there, its integration with respect to x is x square by 2. In the same manner this is. Okay. So theta square by 2. And here limits are 0 to theta naught. First substitute theta naught and minus, next substitute 0. First upper limit you are substitute, after minusing. After doing minus, substitute 0, then we get theta naught minus 0 becomes theta naught only, and already by 2 is this, so theta naught by 2, so it is theta naught by 2. And here, so this is equal to kinetic energy, total work done. Work done may be stored in the form of kinetic energy, or here kinetic energy is converted into work done. So kinetic energy converted into work done means like this only. And from this half gets cancelled, I omega square is equal to C theta naught. It is equation 2. And time, it is time period of oscillation of the coil is T is equal to 2 pi under root I by C. How it is T is equal to 2 pi under root L by G. So L by G, where it is for simple pendulum. In the same manner for the, it is also like a simple pendulum, it oscillates like this. But it is twisting in this manner. So then also time period we look at, the time period is t is equals to 2 pi under root I by c. So that is t pi to 2 pi under root I by c. Squaring on both sides, then it becomes t square. 2 square means 4, pi square. For it, a square root cancel, I by c will be there. From this, I is equals to keep I here only and bring these quantities that side, then becomes, it is in denominator, it comes here, numerator. These two are in numerator, those two goes in denominator. Dividing equation 1 with equation 2. Okay, so equation 1 is what? That is I square omega square is equals to n square a square b square q square. Where is that equation 1? See here. I square omega square n square s, everything are squares. And next, 2, equation 2 is what? I omega square c theta naught square. So that is why dividing equation with 2, then this by this and this. Now omega square only cancel, then this side is what? Next, for I, one I will cancel, only I will be there. I is equals to this formula. But just now we have calculated I value as this one. So comparing equation 3 and 4, then what we get? We get this one. So all are having the squares, so except C. So bring C this side. It is a multiplying here. If it comes, the divide already C is there, it becomes C square. So all the quantities are having square. Take the common. Okay. So it is a whole square is written, then become 2, 4 becomes 2. Okay. And for all the single square is there. Next. Here the square gets cancelled, then what we get? This one we get. Okay. Here, see, this is written this side and it is written this side. Nothing will happen. Now, from this q is equals to, keep here q only and bring remaining quantity other side. With q, n ab is multiplying and they goes in denominator. With q, c theta naught is dividing, they goes upside. Right, already upside t is there, c theta naught. Okay, and see, is finally we have written like this, theta naught is separately written like this. Okay, and let this is except theta naught, let this is as a constant, that is a k. So here see, q charges are directly proportional to the maximum twisting, right? Maximum twisting. Equation was that charge passed through the galvanometer is proportional to, directly proportional to maximum angular deflection or twisting. So how much the charges are flowing, the same amount of twisting will occur. So this is, friend, don't forget